Hi everyone. In this video lecture, we are going to see public address system. Public address system is one of the major application, real-time application we can see of electronic system. And a learner, a student, can be learn lot of things, practically learn lot of things from this one. And one student can design also the public address system. By that design, he or she able to know what is actually happening in the electronic system design. So this is actually one stepping stone to the more detail of this deep sea of electronic systems. So in this lecture, we are going to see basics like block diagram of public address system. Then the heart of this public address system, it is nothing but amplifier. So circuit diagram and working of common emitter amplifier, that is RC coupled to common emitter amplifier, and its frequency response. Then the voltage divider biasing, which is we are using in common emitter amplifier. This much topics are there. So in this video, the first video, I am planning to cover the block diagram of public address system. Okay. In our olden days, many of you may see, I don't know how many of you see this one. Actually, one wedding function is going on, or any other common meeting functions, celebrations were going on. That time, normally we can see this symbol, Ahuja. There is the mic box. Most of the place, we are seeing this name, Ahuja. Then one mic operator is coming, and he is setting all these things, and the meeting is carrying on. Meanwhile, lot of noises are coming. He is coming, then this operator is coming and correcting this one. So actually, where we are seeing one operation of the complete public address system. So actually, what is public address system means? Public. What do you mean by public? A group of people, number of people are sitting together or standing together. It is public. It is for sometime for one meeting, or sometime for some celebration, or some religious reasons may be there, holy mass, something like that. So anyway, the group of people, it may be more than 20 or 30 people, or 10 or 20, 30 people sitting together, and we want to address them for long time, then we are using this one. Because instead of we are using this public addressing system, if we are directly without any mic and support, if we are speaking, after some time we cannot address them long, we may feel pain to our throat because we have to raise our voice louder and louder. So to avoid all those things, we are using one mic, and mic is capturing my voice, and it is amplifying and reproducing with a large sound, and that sound everyone can listen. If it is 100 or 200 people are sitting together, all of them is able to hear my voice or my message or whatever happening there. So to that application, the addressing the public, we are addressing the public, the common a group of large people. Such a system we are designing by using electronics. So in that one, the basic, it's very simple. The basic one is microphone, second one is power amplifier, third one is power amplifier, last one is loudspeaker. It's over. So the electronic sound application and distribution system with a microphone, amplifier and loudspeaker. it is public address system. So the starting end is microphone, or simply we can say phone. Ending side is loudspeaker. It is taking my voice and amplifying, and then reproducing with a large sound. So it reduces the effort of the person who is standing on the stage. Okay. Otherwise, also we can say it is very difficult to address more than 50 or 100 people by a person without this system. So the public address means anything that amplifies. So the name is coming like that. Public means common, a group of people. Address, we are addressing. So assisting that one, we are using public address system. And the system, anything that amplifies sound, so more people and can hear it. It is public address system. These are the four stages. We have seen this one. So first one, we are taking microphone. Transducer. This transducer name, already I mentioned in the video of electronic instrumentation, where what is transducer? Anyway, once again I am repeating, transducer means anything which is converting a physical quantity or physical form of energy to another form of energy. And if we are saying it is electrical transducer or sensor, it is converting physical quantity to electrical signal. So it can be convert heat to electrical signal, temperature to electrical signal. So like that, any mechanical energy to electrical signal. Similarly, here it is converting voice signal, that is sound signal, to electrical signal. So sound signal, you know, it is a longitudinal wave. This longitudinal wave we are converting to a electrical signal with the help of microphone. So it's a transducer. And it is very small amplitude. That's also we have to understand that electrical signal is very small amplitude. Normally we are saying in a communicate system, we will say such a small amplitude, so small frequency, a signal that is generated from a mic, it is normally known as audio signal. So actually audio signal is the converted form of a voice signal in electrical format. So how it is working? This one you may already know. That is, there is one diaphragm, and after that, this diaphragm, there is one coil. Then along that one, there is one magnet field. When sound signal is coming, this diaphragm will start to vibrate like this. When diaphragm is moving front and back like this, this coil will start to move this front and back. And that is inside a magnetic field. So when a coil moving inside a magnetic field, by Faraday's law, there will be one electrical signal generated. That is, there is some EMF form, and for the closed path, it will start to flow current. So this longitudinal movement of sound that generated the movement of sound resulted in the front and back movement of diaphragm, that resulted in the front and back movement of coil, and that is in a magnetic field that generated a small frequency, small amplitude electrical signal. So this electrical signal is actually exact replica of this voice signal. So mic converted this sound energy to a corresponding electrical energy. So this is mic. So all these things are happening here. And there is on switch and off switch. When it is on, then only it will work like that. From there, this electrical signal we have to take. For that one, we are using this plug and cable. Plug in and cable. So different types of mic. You may see this type mic olden days. Now this type mics are not used. So different types of mics are here. Then now we can see this wireless mic. So this audio signal, it is transmitting from here itself. Then that is received by a receiver. Then this receiver is then transmitted to the amplifier. So these two things are together. So there is no cable, cordless mic. Without cable or cord, we can operate it. Second stage is preamplifier. Preamplifier, it is purpose to take the small electrical signal from the microphone and increase the amplitude of signal voltage. So actually this audio signal, it is very small frequency and small amplitude. If you are directly giving a large amplification to this one, that signal may be corrupted, or that small frequency, or sorry, small amplitude signal, it is not able to amplify to a large value suddenly. So we are amplifying this one to an intermediate value, that is, it is 1 millivolt. I want to amplify it to 100 volt. Suddenly it may not be happens, because 1 to 100, it is 100 times. Then 1 milli to 1, again it is 1000 times. So 1 milli to 1, 1000 times. Then there to 100, it is 100 times. Means 10 raised to 5 times, 1 lakh times we have to increase amplitude. Instead of that one, easiest method, 1 milli to 1 volt we can amplify. Then 1 volt to 100 we can again amplify. So the first stage of amplification, initial amplification, they are known as pre-amplifier. The amplifier prior, pre means prior, just before of our actual amplification. It is known as pre-amplifier. Then you can see that the, so from here it is the heart is starting, heart of this public address system. Anyway, we can see the exact, the control, the major important part or heart of the electronic instrument, public address system is power amplifier. So this power amplifier, sometimes you can see this preamplifier may not be there, sometimes it may be there. Anyway, this plug point, one side is connected here, this connector is connected here, it is ending at opposite the plug point, the, from the connector to it is ending at plug point. This plug point we are connecting here. If we are giving preamplification, after preamplification we are connecting to here, or anyway we are connecting that to here. Then this power amplifier give high amplification to the signal. Actually the loudspeaker, to operate loudspeaker we have to give that much amplified signal, amplified voltage signal or current signal. So that much amplification cannot be given by this preamplifier. For that one we require the exact power amplifier. It is amplifying from 1 millivolt to 110 millivolt or 1 volt, that amplification may be done by power amplifier. From there to 100 volt or 1000 volt, that amplification we have to do by using power amplifier in the louds. So this one we are using, by using power amplifier we increase the power of the signal to a large amount, then that signal is able to run, that is able to give to loudspeaker. So different types of power amplifier, you may see these things. So for large addressing system, instead of this type amplifier, we are using this type. Then from there, we are coming to loudspeaker. Loudspeaker is the final part of the public address system. So what is loudspeaker? Simply just opposed to microphone, the incoming electrical signal converting to a sound signal. How? The incoming electrical signal is vibrating the same format of audio signal, but in a large amplitude, high movement is there. That movement is giving to this coil. Then there is magnetic field. So this coil will vibrate. This electrical signal will move the, that is just opposite to generator. When you are giving a electrical signal to a conductor which is placed in the magnetic field, it will start to rotate. That is electrical signal convert to mechanical energy. Same way this electrical signal, it will becomes a mechanical signal, sound signal, and that will vibrate the diaphragm, you will get output signal sound wave. I think you are clear. Thank you.